once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Where the planets, moons, and stars all shimmer, shine. Having a great time exploring space racers.
Hey, wait for me!
Of emergencies in space, you'll need to know how to fix your own visors, cadets. And,
as always,
you'll need to use the right tools.
Oops.
Like I said, the right tool gets the job done.
Yeah, but what's the right tool? Nothing seems to work.
A wrench, my young rockets.
But which one? There's a lot of them.
Let's see.
We've got sucker wrenches, lug wrenches, torque wrenches, monkey wrenches, and a crow's foot wrench. I have the utmost confidence you'll figure it out.
Guess we'll have to try them all.
Why'd they name a wrench after Crow?
Yeah, and what's a monkey?
Huh?
Hey, what's this old book over here? I've never seen it before. Counter Earth. Counter Earth is Earth's twin planet on the other side of the sun. It has all the physical features of Earth, like mountains, deserts, and oceans, but it's uninhabited.
Wow! Counter Earth? Never heard of it.
And if it's identical to Earth, why doesn't anybody live there?
Let's ask. Ava, are you there?
Yes, Robyn. I am always there, and always here as well.
Ava, are you making a joke?
I am a computer. I do not make jokes.
Mm-hmm. Have you heard of a planet called Counter-Earth?
Earth's identical twin planet on the other side of the sun?
One moment. Checking my data bank. No, I have no information on this.
That's strange.
Yeah, because it's right here in Coot's old book. I'm gonna borrow it and read it more carefully.
You sure Coot won't mind if we borrow his book?
No. He always wants us to read and learn. We'll return it tomorrow.
I wonder how come no one's ever mentioned Counter-Earth before, and why we've never seen it.
Maybe because it has an identical orbit to Earth, and Earth and Counter-Earth are always on opposite sides of the sun.
You mean, when we're here, it's there, and when we're there, it's here, with the sun in the middle.
Right. First thing in the morning, I think we should explore the other side of the sun and look for it.
Great idea. Let's check it out.
I'm in. Hey, maybe there'll be a reward for discovering it. Like all the cranberry rocket fuel we want for the rest of our lives.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Probably not.
Oh, maybe not. But let's go anyway.
Booster rockets.
Engage!
Wings.
Back.
Space visors.
Down.
Faster! Halfway around the sun, right?
Ava, what would the coordinates be for Counter-Earth?
Calculating. The distance between Earth and the sun is one astronomical unit, which is 93 million miles. So Counter-Earth should be 93 million miles from the sun as well. Exactly on the other side.
Thanks!
How will we recognize it?
Well, it should look just like Earth. Ice, mountains, volcanoes, oceans.
Totally.
Phew, that took forever.
Really? Well, it should be somewhere around here. But where?
I don't see a planet that looks like Earth. There's nothing here but space.
Yeah, nothing but lots of nothing.
We must be in the wrong place.
Ava, anything?
You have arrived at your destination.
We have?
Wait! Look over there, guys!
Woohoo! Counter-Earth!
Finally!
Look! There's ice, like on the North Pole.
And there's a stratovolcano 20,000 feet high, just like in Africa.
Hey, a valley just like Death Valley.
This planet absolutely must be Counter-Earth.
Maybe we should explore it more closely. You know, just to be sure.
Yeah, that way what we're looking at is what we think we're looking at.
This looks just like the Grand Canyon on Earth.
It does look like the Grand Canyon, but different. Wait a minute. No, this can't be...
Can't be what?
This is Mount Sharp, next to the Gale Crater. And this atmosphere, it's not like Earth. And this planet looks sort of kind of reddish.
You're right. This isn't like the pictures in Coot's book.
That's because this isn't Counter-Earth. It's Mars!
Mars? How can that be?
I'm not sure.
But Ava gave us the coordinates. Ava, did you make a mistake?
Rechecking coordinates now. My coordinates were correct, Cadet Eagle. Perhaps you flew too far around the sun. Wait, I have located another planet approximately the same size as Earth.
Could that one be Counter-Earth?
The only way to know is to explore it. This planet is only 74 million miles from here.
Oh, 74 million miles! 74 million miles!
Let's try it! We can't give up now.
Eagle! Robyn! What's the hurry?
Look, clouds, just like Earth.
But how can we see through the clouds to know for sure?
Ava, enhance visibility, please.
Visor radar now on, cadets.
I see mountains and valleys.
I see deserts and craters.
I see something blue. Just kidding. Okay, okay. So you guys think this really is Counter-Earth?
Let's take a closer look.
Wait a minute. These clouds are made of sulfuric acid.
And the desert surface is hotter than mercury. Hot enough to melt lead.
And us!
And the planet is rotating in retrograde. The opposite direction that Earth rotates. No way. This can't be right.
Ava must have made a mistake. The poisonous cloud cover, the hot surface temperature, the rotation in the opposite direction. This planet must be Venus.
But how can Ava make a mistake? She never makes mistakes.
Ava, we think you sent us to Venus by accident.
Oh, I am so sorry, Robyn. I must have miscalculated while my system was rebooting. I now have a new set of coordinates for you.
Not again! Isn't it lunchtime yet?
I am quite certain you will find what you have been looking for.
What do you think, guys? One more try?
They say third time's the charm.
Who says that?
They do.
I can't wait to get home after all this searching around. I'm starving.
Yeah, I'm a little hungry too.
I just feel silly for mistaking Mars and Venus for Counter-Earth.
Hey, no one's perfect, Robyn.
This is me we're talking about, Hawk.
Look, everyone. What's that up ahead? Could it be...
Counter-Earth!
Look, there are islands and oceans of water.
A North Pole.
A desert. It kind of looks like Earth.
I think it looks just like Earth.
I agree. This place looks exactly like the pictures in Coot's book.
Yeah!
Woo! This is just like a desert on Earth. Different types of cactus. Oh, look! Some are even blooming. I can't wait to tell everyone!
Coot's gonna be so proud of us.
Let's call him!
Ava, please connect us to Coot.
Connecting now.
Yes, Robyn?
We found a book of yours yesterday. All about a twin planet called Counter-Earth. So we decided to try and find it. And guess what? We have! We're there right now!
Well, that's wonderful news.
It took a lot of investigation.
No doubt. Please, bring back some evidence from the planet's surface for testing.
Outstanding work, cadets!
Done!
Ready!
Time to za-za-zoom home!
At this altitude, you will reach Stardust Bay in 11 minutes.
Say what?
11 minutes? That's not possible.
Is there a twin version of Stardust Bay on Counter-Earth?
Maybe. Or maybe Ava's sick. She has been acting weird all day.
Computers don't get sick.
But they do malfunction.
Whoa! Ava is right this time!
There are rockets here? And they look just like the ones back home.
Wait, how is this possible?
Headmaster Crane would like you to report to his office immediately, cadets.
I knew we shouldn't have taken Coot's book. We're in trouble now!
Welcome home, cadets!
We're really confused.
We're on Earth, Hawkey, not Counter-Earth.
But that book says Counter-Earth is Earth's twin planet on the opposite side of the sun.
We looked and looked, but...
Counter-Earth? It doesn't actually exist.
What do you mean it doesn't exist? We read about it in your book.
This book is science fiction. Counter-Earth is a make-believe planet in storybooks.
So none of it was true?
Unfortunately not. Sorry, cadets.
Ah, lugnuts.
From now on, you need to ask if what you read is truth or fiction.
But why would you have us go all around the solar system looking for something that's not there?
Every year, we teachers play an April Fool's joke on the cadets.
And this year, the joke was your search for Counter-Earth.
You wanted us to find the book?
Yes. We knew you'd be curious.
To look for a planet that doesn't exist? You really had us going.
But Ava gave us coordinates.
Yes. Ava was in on the whole thing, you see, to help us create this April Fool's joke for you.
To make the experience seem more real. Your samples seem similar to those from Earth because...
They really were from Earth!
April Fools!
Gotcha, cadets!
Good one.
As a wise rocket once said, you can't always believe what you read.
Nothing can replace thorough investigation.
And first-hand observation.
So I only have one more question.
Yes, Hawk? Ask away, young cadet.
Can we please have lunch now?